Lane Older now in the second semi-final. First four into the final. Colombia in lane one, Canada in lane two, West Germany in lane three, France in lane four, Bulgaria in lane five, United States in lane six, Ghana in lane seven, and China in lane eight. And the big team here, the United States of America. Just looking down the track, by the way, although Colombia are drawn in lane number one, I can't see a Colombian athlete there at the moment, so they may have withdrawn. Alice Brown, the leadoff lady for the American team, has done 10.92, coached, by the way, by Andrea Lynch, the former British champion sprinter. Very, very fast starter indeed. Didn't make the individual event. She's number one for the Americans. On the second leg, Sheila Eccles. She's run inside 11 seconds this season, 10.86. Then we've got the flying Florence Griffith Joyner, Olympic gold medalist in 100 metres and 200 metres. She's on the third leg. And Evelyn Ashford on the fourth leg, the former world record holder. So it's some team. Getting ready in lane number two is Angela Bailey for Canada. They've got a good team. Angie Phipps on the second leg. Isayenko, Commonwealth champion, on the third leg. And Katie Anderson on the last. Ron Pickering was making the point earlier that you usually put your strongest sprinter on the second leg. Interesting that the Americans have opted to put Florence Griffiths Joyner on the third leg, but she is the noted Ben runner. The French have got a useful squad out, and so too have the West Germans. Alice Brown got the Olympic silver medal in Los Angeles. There's Sheila Eccles waiting on the second leg. Takes over from Brown. And the Colombians, I can confirm, are not starting. So seven to go, four to go into the final later. Florence Griffiths Joyner. What a game she's had, and what a season she's had as well. So they're called forward, a check on the order. Canada on the inside in lane two, West Germany in three, France in four, Bulgaria in five, the Americans in six, Ghana in seven, China in eight. Four to qualify for the final later this afternoon. Good start. Bulgarians have gone off very quickly. They've got a good squad there. But it's America all the way. A tremendous leg by Alice Brown. Hands on to Sheila Eccles now. Good exchange too. And the Americans with a big lead. The Canadians trailing at the moment. France are going well, and so too are the West Germans. Into the third change. Eccles now to Florence Griffith Joyner. And not a good change. Far too close, but absolutely safe. And the Americans away and clear. And the former world record holder on the last leg. Evelyn Ashford seemed to go early. She had to wait a second. And West Germany closed then very quickly. In third place, Bulgaria. And in fourth place, France. The Americans come home in front. They qualify. West Germany second. Bulgaria third. And France in fourth place, with the Canadians not qualifying. The time not as fast as in the first semi-final. 42.01, that was one in. 42.12. And the American changing, well, was a bit ordinary. From two to three, and from three to four. Got a feeling, actually, that Evelyn Ashford went off a bit early then, even for the speed of Florence Griffiths. This is the exchange I'm talking about. Watch the Americans. They lost a lot of ground here. Just got it inside the zone, and I didn't see a red flag go up. And that, of course, was the leg on which the Americans were penalised and thrown out of the men's competition yesterday. They've got to get that right, because they lost an awful lot of time. Let's watch them all the way around. Now, this was a beautiful start by Alice Brown. She is one of the best starters in the world. And she ran right away from the opposition on this leg. And the Americans were so far in front, and this was a very good exchange indeed. There we go. Smack on. Now, there's a problem here. Going in, actually, Eccles looks so relaxed there. She's not really powering her way down that back straight. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. You can see her searching for the baton there. They lost a bit of ground there. And now watch Griffith Joyner handing to the former world record holder, Evelyn Ashford, who got the silver medal behind her in the individual 100 metres. Now, Ashford's gone early. And has to sort of dwell to get the baton at all within the zone. So they can polish up on that, and they'll have to do, actually, if they are going to beat the Soviet Union and the East Germans. First
field event. David, I think Florence Griffith Joyner coming in there shouted weight rather than hand. The Americans normally shout hand, although they shouldn't have to. It should be an automatic response. After six strides, the hand should go back. But there was a big, good deal of yelling there, and I think they've got to get their act together. Back to the drawing board for the Americans. Meanwhile, I can tell you that the Great Britain squad, they actually finished sixth on the photograph. Their time, 43.50. Still a very creditable effort. That's the Great Britain women's 4x100 meters, 43.50.
Going back to the decision to disqualify the American men's relay team yesterday with that exchange on the last leg, that was from Kelvin Smith to Lee McNeil. Carl Lewis was saying this morning that in fact he believes the American coach is entirely responsible for the error. There's been trouble in the relay team all the way along, with Carl Lewis in opposition to Russ Rogers, the American track coach. Carl Lewis reportedly wants his clubmate, Joe DeLoach, in the team, the guy who won the 200 metres, and probably he was right. But having said all that, they elected not to run Lewis in the qualifying rounds and used a squad that Lewis believes they should not have used. He maintains that they should have chosen, in the early rounds, the squad that was going to run the final and get used to each other in a rather better manner than they had done in training. And in fact, of course, he then went on to say, well, they put Lee McNeil on the anchor leg, a leg he's never run in his life, and they paid the penalty.
Yes, one can understand the substitution of 400 meter runners to rest them, but not to substitute 100 meter runners, because they need all the rehearsal and all the practice they can get. So the In a sense, Carl Lewis was right, but the coach should have had that order sorted anyway.